one of the striking things in your statement, you say book sales are resilient, especially print. Does this mean that the e-book phenomenon has had its day?
No, it doesn't mean that at all, but it does mean there's been a big resurgence in print. Print sales have been up 8% in the year. E-book sales slightly tailed off at 2%. But the great news story for our company and the industry is that the industry had its highest ever level of sales in the last year. It was record-breaking for books and journals.
Why was that? Why are people just rediscovering the magic of books and reading?
Well, perhaps people's lives are so dominated by screens these days that they like to get back to the written word on the page or on an e-book reading device and seek their escape as well as their information that way.
Well, as we mentioned, it's 20 years since Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone was published. You've got some new editions coming out to mark the occasion. I mean, surely every house in the country must have a copy of this book by now.
Well, it's unbelievable. I saw them for the first time this morning, the 8 new editions of Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone that will come out in a couple of weeks at the beginning of June. They're in the house colours of Hogwarts, Slytherin, Hufflepuff, Raven. For Gryffindor, and they're very bright colours. The hardcovers are striped, the paperbacks sheer colours. So I think people will go mad like buying the Manchester United away shirt, even if they've got it already.
Is that how you regard these propices almost? I mean, they are like football replica shirts.
No, not remotely. I'm drawing an analogy there, Ian. But your viewers would be mad not to buy them.
So another big title that you publish, of course, is Wisden. You say that Wisden's had a very good year. Why was that? What was behind that?
Well, the popularity of the sport is ever growing. We had a lovely moment this year because not only do we publish Wisden, but also its sister volume, Wisden India. And we have a brilliant article in it by no less than the chief executive of Microsoft, Satya Nadella, about how captaincy of his cricket team when young taught him much of what he knows about leadership today. And that's the joy of Wisden, that cricket brings together what so many people love most in their lives.
Very high-powered audience, yeah. Now, among the authors who did quite well for you this year, Raymond Blanc, who we've had on the show in the past, Tom Kerridge, when are people going to get tired of cookery books?
Well, cookery, it's the thing that people do 3 times a day, 7 days a week. The success of Tom Kerridge was just phenomenal. We got back from Christmas. We didn't know what would happen. His book came out on the 12th of January. There's a picture of Tom on the back of the jacket holding his old trousers from before he lost 11 stone doing his own dopamine diet. Be thin, be happy. No wonder it was number one for many weeks in the Sunday Times list.
And very briefly, you also published the speeches of Barack Obama. How did that go down?
Terrifically well. Now, it seems that the new president isn't popular with absolutely everyone, and one way of expressing that was to buy the speeches of Barack Obama, which people did right after he left office in those dark days.
All right, Nigel Newton from Bloomsbury. Got to leave it there. Great to see you.